not part of the bar watch because it's not a bar. Liquor inspectors, we've got four of us under our, and the problem is that the kind of special events that happen here, I think we all think are fantastic, and I know folks who participate and it's great, but again, it all comes back to the operator. And that makes me very uneasy, and I feel trying to be progressive and, you know, interesting business model and all that, but it's just very hard to support it because I can just see the downside of it as well. So I think I'm feeling very similar to Councilor Gudgeon. I'd like it to work on principle. It makes me really uncomfortable trying to be fair and adjudicating it in a study spot like this. And I, you know, I don't want to feel like that. That's the worst possible position to be in. And I think it speaks to, as I say, creating a hybrid on the fly that has never been contemplated or regulated. And if you were going to say we're going to do this for special events, and this is a venue for special events, yeah, like the Victoria Event Center, fantastic. But when you're trying to do both, that's one of the hidden problems, and it does all come down to manage your policy.
Thank you, Chris. I share the concern, and we have a history in this particular industry as well as some others around the table. What I see is an operator who is trying to make things work from their perspective. They have the special event opportunity or the special event license opportunity, but they're trying to take down that administrative detail to do other stuff. But they have said very clearly that they're following the business model of one of the competitors just across the street, and yet they're going outside that. So I have a concern not only that does this create an unusual impact on us that we don't fully understand, it also then gets all the other different operators here that are recognized in the report and Ambrosia to then say, okay, we need to expand as well to be competitive. And so I prefer the original recommendations put forward by staff. If you want to test it out, and test it here, make sure it isn't acting as an opportunity for late night people needing one other place to come to an operator that isn't part of Bar Watch, isn't part of the expansion of Bar Watch in Vancouver to include restaurants, but we're not there yet. So it creates
Thank you. I'm going to go ahead and do that.